more complication, hardly any solution to the pollution. Respected principal ma'am, members of the jury, teachers, and my learned friends, I'm very sorry to say that I'm totally against the statement that Orient Formula in Delhi is the right step to control air pollution. As Delhi's government tries to bring down pollution level with the help of ordinance scheme is failing to deliver its purpose. CM Mr. Kejriwal himself said that this scheme is a weapon to be used on temporary basis to curb pollution level. In my opinion, ordinance schemes implemented without analyzing and thinking about pros and cons should not be tried as an experiment, because Delhi, our capital city, is not a laboratory to perform experiment. I think implementation of ordinance policy will not bring any of the significant change in existing pollution levels. And actually, it hasn't brought any of the desirable change even during ordinance periods. Various studies like IIT Kanpur reports that private cars account only 1% of air pollution. As today's cars are CNG and petrol-based and are equipped with good engines and new technologies leading to zero pollution. The Delhi Pollution Panel admits that particulate matter 10 levels of pollution went high during ordinance period. The comparative study findings obtained from 74 centres of Delhi anti-pollution body indicated no significant change in pollution level during ordinance scheme. Alarmingly, this scheme has confirmed rise in pollution as cases of respiratory illness went high during sweeping traffic curves. Now, I want to ask my opponent friends, tell me, have you ever tried to see why pollution is increasing day by day? Have you ever tried to look at the trucks which are more than 15 years old emit coal black smoke while running on Delhi roads? Have you ever tried to look at the commercial vehicles, our diesel vehicles, which emit more than 28% of total air pollutants? Have you ever tried to look at the drivers of cars, taxis, Fatpar Seva, who park their vehicles on roadsides with engine on for a long time? Environmentalists said that these vehicles emit more than 32% of total air pollution. So friends, the real culprit is not ordinary numbered vehicles, but the highly toxic diesel. In this regard, Paris has set an example by phasing out these vehicles. China has already banned them, and I'm shocked to notice that these vehicles are exempted from this ordinance policy. Friends, exemption should be done on the basis of polluting nature of vehicles. Mind it, exemption always leaves a room for misuse. That's what autowalas and taxiwalas are doing with deadlines by rising their fuel. We all know that government has borrowed this idea from foreign cities. What do you think? If it worked in London, it will work in Delhi too? Friends, keep a note that public transport in London is like a web. Delhi is nowhere near. Dusre deshon ki nakal, Delhi mein bagair nakal. And in Mexico and Colombia, people have started buying second-hand ordinary number vehicles, leading to more pollution and congestion. Delhi is no short of rich people who can't do that. Lesser traffic, but bad air. Means pain plan. I think providing a healthy public transport, increasing parking charges, carpooling, metros, creating pedestrian only zones near shopping malls and busy streets will work more effectively rather than forcing upon people ordering cabs, because crude enforcement won't clean Delhi's environment, but your own will work. To conclude, I would like to say that we all should concentrate for creating solutions for problems rather than problems for solutions. Thank you and have a great day.